Don't see what's so wrong about liking cereals. They're fun.
Udon takes it to an unhealthy level.
Does he act them out while they're going on at the same time? I got a friend who does that. Not saying they're weird, just saying that's what they do.
Oh, maybe. All right.
There we go. Seems like there's some tension between the board and Groundbreaker.
You noticed, huh?
A little bit. I'm bright like that. I like to make sure that I show off my intelligence anytime I get, when I can, if I can.
They can't abide an independent township, especially not one they gotta depend on. We're the first and last stop out of this colony. All their interstellar freighters come through us, and we skim a few bits off the top and manifest processing fees with every one. Folks around here will bluster that the board hates our freedom, but really, they know we can stop their out-system shipments anytime we like, and that terrifies them.
Why can't Groundbreaker and the board just work together?
You sure you didn't just step off one of the interstellar freighters? There's no working with the board. They don't share, not bits, people, or resources. You work for them, or you don't work at all. Groundbreaker cooperating now would be tantamount to joining their ranks, and we sure as shit ain't about to do that.
Glad it terrifies them, the bastards. Keep pushing them.
It's a delicate balance, right? We could cancel their freighter's docking privileges in retaliation, but where'd that lead us? They got assault cruisers, gunships, and a handful of mining operations at their fingertips. We push them too hard, maybe they decide we'd be better in 10 trillion little pieces. Or they cobble together a new Groundbreaker and put us out of business.
The board wouldn't do that, would they?
It's a tough line to walk, no doubt about that. But we may do all right. So far, anyway.
Thanks.
Sure thing.
All right, Wheeler. Last thing, we're gonna get a good drink.
Most places are on the promenade deck. Big door yonder, straight through security. There's a bar on the starboard side. I got a preference for the Lost Hope myself. Talk to Vera. She'll set you right.
Which way is starboard? Aren't they're all stars around?
It means on your right side. Reckon you're from one of the planets. Word of advice. You see a door marked opens to vacuum? Stay clear.
What if I need to clean up a mess, like I spilled crumbs on a carpet or something?
That's not the kind of vacuum. You know what? Never mind. Open any door you want. The mess will take care of itself.
Oh, I love this guy.
Be seeing you.
You know what? Just might be good if we sterilize you. It just beneficial to everybody. Flores. Hey, here we go.
Unless you're here to file an incident report or to inquire about the bounty posting, I must kindly ask you to clear out. The Mardet's offices aren't for leisure time nor loitering.
Ooh, Gratzinder. What about bounties?
Got a hot one for you. Captain Gunner McRed, just 26 hours old. The posting, that is, not the criminal. Allegations include several counts of flying under the influence, carrying open alcoholic containers, failure to pay docking fees, resisting arrest, and assaulting not one, but two officers.
I am kind of happy that she did mention the difference between him, the warrant being 26 hours old and not the person, because I am more than positive if she didn't say it, there would have been a dumb line for it. More than positive.
Swerving in the air was more like it. Then he crashed hard into the dock and tumbled out of his ship and fled on foot. Spilled Rizzo's Violet Spectrum vodka all over Officer Hartley. An affront of its own, considering none of us are approved for anything higher than Green Spectrum.
Wait, you have to be approved for the better shit of alcohol?
Oh, that's just...
I don't even like alcohol, and I know that's offensive. Any leads on where I might find McRed? Backred?
Last tip we got pointed toward the back bays. You want the reward? Do the legwork.
Yes, ma'am. I'll take the posting.
You and about six other enterprising mavericks. It's only a matter of time before someone brings me McRed's head, or his lucky lighter, as proof of kill. I do hope you're the lucky hunter, though. Good luck and skip speed to you.
No fingers, huh? What's it like working security detail on a space station?
Do I look like your gossipy best friend?
A little bit.
While I'm on post, I take my duties real serious. I would have no qualms whatsoever escorting you to a cell. Understand?
Just so you know, my safe word is, bunk buddies. Okay. Fine, fine.
Then get to business or get moving.
What's a Mardet?
We're the security force here on Groundbreaker. Started back before the crossing, you know.
Why Mardet, not guard or officer?
The original force was made up of a Marine detachment from the 77th Marine Expeditionary Unit, Trailward Fleet. Folks started calling us Mardets because it was easier to say. Guess it stuck.
Hmm. All right. Like a little bit of lore there.
Hi there. Haven't seen you around before. What can Groundbreaker Security do for you today?
Just getting my bearings. What do you do here?
This is the security desk, sir. If you're here to report a crime, you'll want to talk to Commandant Sunita. I'm not authorized to take incident reports anymore.
Oh, now why can't you?
I'm not so good at filing. Mix up first name and surname 1, 2, 7 times. Well, folks are liable to start taking your filing privileges away.
It just sounds so like, oh, I was having fun filing papers too. Do you do, I don't know, tours or something?
We can't just let anyone walk in here. I wouldn't be, we just don't. Maybe if you clear an open bounty and get in good with Commandant Sunita, or help Chief Tennyson fix this heat, that might warrant a thank you tour or something.
Mm-hmm. Any chance you'll, bribe? Oh, right, I forgot to pay the filing fee. That was 1,000 bits? Yes. Any chance to change mine?
Well, let me think about it for a minute. No?
Okay, it's fine. I take your meaning.
Appreciate it. You being so understanding and all.
I can't tell if he's just like, if he's just shy and naive, or he's actually denser than I am. What if some of that contraband's mine and I'm coming to claim it?
That'd be awful weird. On account of you should be locked up back here too, then.
Okay.
All right.
I bet you got seized contraband from all of the system?
Sure. And stuff from outside the system too, off the interstellar freighters. That's why we also have so many armed Mardets on duty here. All right.
He's a special boy. Lots of freighters come through the station, yeah? Must keep you busy?
Less than there used to be. Fewer freighters passing through these days. I spend some shifts just listening to the wireless.
Why aren't there as many freighters?
Search me. I mean, don't search me, because that's my job. Get it? I reckon you'd have to ask the folks in Byzantium.
Okay, well, see you around. Her body's like, wait a minute, I'm sorry. Did you want to get in here too? Oh, well, what you gotta do is just be a super ninja and then go through the wall. Yeah, chat, clearly that's what you gotta do. God, I really hope this is not gonna be bad. Arty farty pavarty, yep. So, okay.
I picked up this weird signal the other day. It was coming from Monarch.
Here we go again.
Okay, wait a minute. If I go...
Monarch, it's a wasteland. You're hearing things.
Wait.
There was a lot of...
Oh, we could go in there if we wanted to.
Said his name was Graham?
Mardet.
Right. Broadcasting on a...
Oh, hey, Wheeler.
Now I've heard everything.
I guess there would be a door to your room,
you know,
in there.
It takes more muscles to frown than to smile.
Who told you that?
Grand. Oh my god, this looks so good!
A hard cider for a hard life.
Wizzos, bye now. Hard cider chat.
Rizzo's Knock You Out Bar, a CCN 76 milk chocolate bar with caramel and pea-free nuts in it. It's time for a KYO.
KYO? You know, I wonder what that would taste like, right?
Might we expect you out here again?
Like, chocolate liqueur candy bar that has a little bit of alcohol in it, a little bit of nut. That actually might be pretty good. Yeah.
But I didn't think it was that bad.
I heard there's been a rash of conveyor losses on all routes.
This is Halcyon News. We interrupt your regular...
Seeking relief from the heat? Till June Lay gets those radiators fixed, I've got the next best thing.
Zero G, I don't suppose you know a way to get the Stellar Bay or a Monarch.
Stellar Bay proper? Tough to say. The board recalled all the nav keys about 10 years back when the corpse pulled back to Terra 2.
Do you know why?
It's overrun with beasts, I heard. Big ones.
Like
kinda
primals?
Chew your face off for fun. Might all be board propaganda, though. If you're aiming to get to Stellar Bay, you're gonna have to get your hands dirty. The board don't like them that truck with Monarch. But I ain't the one you ought to be asking. Try Gladys on the promenade. She'll fix you up.
Alright, let's see here. All the traders in the system come through here. Heard anything interesting?
Only the usual. Marauders all over space. You ever wonder how folk who can't figure the bleeding edge technology of a spoon can manage to get ships into space?
Yep. It's this heat issue I keep hearing about.
The radiators, they're fucked 10 ways to Sunday. And we're all sweating buckets wondering when the powers that be are gonna get around to fixing it.
I probably should go, but I thought space was cold. Are you telling me it's hot?
Groundbreakers, what do you call it? Like in a terrarium.
A closed system, you mean?
Yeah, what she said. Can't let the outside, that is space, in, or we all die a horrifying airless death. Still gotta let the heat out, though. Or we cook. And right now, we're cooking.
Here's the strange thing. I remember playing Dragon Age Origins, chat. There is a character as a dwarf in that game. I forget his name, but he's a savant when it comes to, like, enchantment. But he only speaks enchantment. I'm somehow envisioning our character something like that. Right, like, somehow he knows engineering really, 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 really good, really well. But he's dumber than bricks. Sounds like I have an issue with your thermal control system.
Couldn't say, and I wouldn't be pouring drinks professionally if I could. All I know is we're cooking in our own juices here, and it's only gonna get worse.
So what do you need radiators for?
They're supposed to gather up all the heat the systems generate and vent it into space. Instead of the heat going where it ought, though, it seems to be blowing straight down the promenade.
How long it's been like this?
Weeks? I lost track. Too lawdamn long.
Law. The law.
Who's in charge of fixing it?
Engineering. Chief June Lay Tennyson, to be precise. She runs this heap. Best she can, anyway.
All right.
Don't know what's got her dragging her heels, but I wish she'd hurry it up.
Well, good luck with that.
Luck's nothing against the cold void of space. But sure, good luck to us.
What do you know about her?
There's nobody who knows more about the station's guts. Any system you could name, June's crawled around inside and made it better. She doesn't come around here often, though. Don't see her as much of a drinker. Too straight lace for that.
What you got?
What ain't I got?
What? All right, well, I mean, if you want to go that route, let's go with some dehydrated water, because chat. One of these had melee. That's weapon sway. Dexterity. Hey, it's apple juice. Is that expensive? Well, hot damn. Miss Beers, hey, morning. So if you guys are just joining, We're in a brand new area called Groundbreaker. I might have done the bad thing and ended up killing Edgewater in the very same way you would Fallout 3 take out that first town that you go to with the bomb and the nuclear and the boom boom. Yep.
Romantic, bacon with Edna.
So, yeah. It was an accident. Sort of. Kind of. Ish. Ish. Where are we going here? Wait, how did I... Oh, that wrapped all the way around.
We interrupt your regularly scheduled advertisement for the following...
Do you need to raise the price of apple and pear juice by a lot? Any particular reason, or are you just downing it like it's going out of habit? Spicer. Gladys. Nice to meet you. Wait a minute. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, no, we got, I want to make sure I got all the best booths. Dialogue booth, dialogue booth. All right, here we go.
Bless my heart. A stranger come knocking on a poor old woman's door. You here for a particular reason? Or did the neighbors tell you how good my sugar cookies are? Made without a single natural ingredient or an oven. Just like store-bought.
Okay, I love how she's like,
well, hello there, young man. I am the bloodthirsty fence. Now, if you screw me over, I will find you, and I will use duct tape to otherwise give you a good old-fashioned granny stripping.
That's a goat. Wait, we'll steal you some. Yep, yeah, yep, yep. Hey, I'm not a klepto.
It's just so shiny.
Phineas sent me. Said you could sell me a Navkey Stellar Bay.
Those have been the height of illegality since Stellar Bay turned their noses up at the board. You and I could be thrown to the void just for discussing such a transaction.
Oh, now she's serious.
Lucky for us, Groundbreaker's a free port. We're outside of the board's control. For the time being, at least. Now, I only have the one Navkey. And they're hard to come by these days. It won't be cheap. If you find yourself lacking in the bits, I might have an opportunity you'd be interested in.
My bits are perfectly where they're at, lady. All right. Whoa! 10,000 bits! Holy shit! I barely broke 4,000. And I have been... borrowing everything that I see that's not locked down and selling what I don't need. Yes. Any chance of a discount since, you know, Phineas sent me?
Phineas, that old kook. He was quite the dancer back in his prime, did he tell you? Real light on his feet.
Yeah, I can kind of see it.
Real light in the wallet, too. He still owes me a small fortune. Laws, maybe I should charge you double.
Oh, no, 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 no. Ooh! A little nervous, I'll be like, and it's 20,000. Be like, oh, shit. All right, well. So that's a no, right?
Bless your heart.
I know. I love that some people are like, oh God, this guy's too stupid. It's just, all right, you know what? It's not his fault. You know what? Maybe he was dropped as a baby. Maybe. Bad living environment, right? Air wasn't properly terraformed or something. Not the parents' fault, just that he got stuck in the wrong situation at the wrong time. There you go. All it is. Tell me about this opportunity.
Well, I find I'm in need of a ship captain with a little more flexibility. Might be this could help out the Groundbreaker, as well as earn some bits. But if you've got qualms...
What other jobs do you know about? All right, no qualms here. I mean, lady, I just accidentally took out an entire town... And I'm pretty sure some of the people are locked in their house and they're actually going to survive because Spacer's Choice, because they're so damn cheap, did not put like a emergency release valve on any of the doors in case of a power outage because cheap. Cheap, cheap.
Do you know Edna over in engineering? Sweet as a pea, that one. On occasion, she'll pass along transmissions I might find interesting.
Uh-huh.
She sent me a recording of a distress signal she'd scraped from the Groundbreaker's comm array. Curious thing is, it came from an outpost called Roseway. and Angie Cleo abandoned that place years ago.
Hey, say no more. I am in. I would have said that, chat. I would have.
But I must say, oh no, a ghost message?
Aren't you precious? No, the young man on the video was flesh and blood, all right.
Could be it was automated. Mr. Thompson used to automate the intercom in Edgewater to say all sorts of things. A bit saved is worth two in the bush was his favorite. Never did figure out what he meant.
Edna didn't seem to think so, and I trust the dear girl's judgment. Maybe not in men, but she knows her comms. So, like as not, someone's been down there recently. And if someone set up shop in Roseway, I'd wager they got something to hide.
And I wager that there is a acid steeper at Roseway so that I can get Sam up and running and I can have a cleaning bot and a killing bot. Twofer. If it's a corporate town with something to hide, why the OSOS?
Maybe whatever they're hiding went to heck. And now they need a few spare hands to clean up the mess.
Oh, that's adorable. She said heck.
If you should find a secret worth selling, might be I could find a buyer. Corporate bigwigs will pay top bit for inside information on their competitors. The more we got the corps fighting each other, the less time they got to meddle in our affairs.
So you need someone to snoop around for you then, eh? My services don't come cheap.
Neither do mine, dearie. Old Gladys knows the value of good work. You'll be compensated accordingly, I can promise you that. Should you find yourself responding to
welcome
a certain
morning.
Distress call,
do I remember
so
a
doing,
Fizzle
find
Wizard
yourself
1973?
Certain valuable corporate secrets, well,
vaguely?
Then we ought to have a chat over a pot of tea and my famous cookies.
This sounds shady. No, thank you. You know what? You can count on me.
Law bless your Adams. Here's a copy of the SOS recording, complete with the coordinates.
Cool.
Don't forget to come find old Gladys when you're done.
Okie dokie. Any other jobs you know about?
Might want to acquaint yourself with Junlei Tennyson, Groundbreaker's chief. She's been trying to get a handle on this heat problem we've got. You'll find her fretting in engineering. I'd say she's a sweet girl, but law for Fen someone call me a liar.
Trade. What do we got?
I found a handsome ceramic mantipillar at a salvage auction last week.
I don't even know what that is, so okay. Holy biscuits. If that was a melee weapon, that'd be perfect. Sorry, Swedish. Should mention that I'm terrible with names sometimes. Especially if I haven't seen the person in over 6 months to a year. Typically. Archive cartridge, Hephaestus. Data cartridge contains the public records of Hephaestus mining outposts on Skyla. Be viewed using the captain's terminal on Unreliable. Ah, battered Marta datapad. Datapad. Old datapad once used by the Groundbreaker's Marta security forces. The accumulated dust and grime, this has been accessed for over a decade. Come back to these. I think these might be important. All right, I'm gonna buy that. Will? Oh, I can't sell. Wait, no. I should be able to sell to you. Yeah, I should be able to sell to you. Mm-hmm. Thought so. All right. Where's that pristine one? Huh. We had a pristine weapon here that we were gonna sell off. Did we already sell it? Might have. Let me take a look here. Bravati, you don't have. No, you have that. Right. Okay. Let's go ahead and break that down. Hang on to that. Break that down. we'll try having Bravada use. Yeah. We'll try having her use the shrink ray, and then if everything goes sideways, we'll go from there. All right, let me go by location and region. All right, so we got Groundbreaker, Solution. Purchase a nav key to Stellar Bay. All right, that's the one we want. Oh, Alrighty. Go over there.
Sure.
Leave me alone. Ah, requires a rest and go key card. I'm not stealing, I'm borrowing. I promise I'll put it back. Oh. Damn it. Got excited of a nun, Jeff. Oh, I am gonna need those. Okay, so there's a new. All right.
On my way.
Space Marine to Indiana Jones, basically. Yeah. Point that way, no enlargement rate. Better to go klepto than key card. Yeah, permanently borrowing. Yes, exactly. You don't have perfect. You don't permanently borrow? You're missing out. Yeah. I love how it's considered trash because it's in the trash. Why am I seeing red marks? Oh, I'm supposed to come back to you. Okay. The boards in Barville ensures that nothing can leave. Oh my god, this looks so cool. I gotta talk to this man.
I'm sorry about the heat. Chief Tennyson will get the radiators fixed soon. Of course, this heat sure makes a zero-G brew extra refreshing. It's an ale that's good for what ails you. Oh, and it's not the best choice, it's Spacer's choice. Taste the freedom. Lot of slogans to keep track of. Sometimes I forget.
I've got to ask you about your hat, sir.
I'm bound to satisfy headgear-related inquiries. Please send any complaints to our Consumer Care Headwear Division.
Are you doing all right in there?
Oh, I'm having a stellar day. And not just because I'm legally obligated to say so. Almost as stellar as a Spacer's Choice is affordable.
Can you see in there?
I can see all of the top quality merchandise in the Spacer's Choice catalog, which is available here at a reasonable price.
How do you brush your teeth?
Spacer's Choice regrets that we don't sell toothpaste at this time, but we're always working on delivering exciting new products to our customers. Sprout wash, mouthwash, and mantifloss are among the exciting line of dental goods currently in development.
So what you're telling me is nobody's been able to brush their teeth in 10 years, if not longer. Do you miss eating solid food? Oh my god. I wonder if this is how people feel when they have to like wear those outfits for adverts, right? Just like some random dude walking and be like, can you see in there? Is it hot in there? Do you need a straw? You need a fan?
Don't miss out on these deals. You'll find none like them on all of Groundbreaker or anywhere in the Halcyon Colony.
Do you have to sleep with that on?
Trouble sleeping? Try our Lunar Eclipse Mix. That's two handfuls of pep pills washed down with a hearty swig of two-hour energy brew. The blast will send you through the stratosphere and the crash will knock you out gold guaranteed.
Does Spacer's Choice make you wear that?
Add an additional 10% to your purchase today,
oh,
and the proceeds will be donated to Spacer Cares, our premier corporate welfare program. At Spacer's Choice, we care about your health and emotional well-being. That's why we put Martin through 6 years of vendor school, only to make him wear this hat.
Oh my god. It's like, I have 2 degrees in marketing, and yet this is what they give me. Should have been somewhere else, but I can't complain. Do you need help to get out of there?
Even if my contract didn't forbid it, I think it's part of me now. Now, are you ready to make Spacer's Choice Lunar Green Moonmouth lozenges a part of you? Lunar Green, the future is spearmint.
Where can I get a hat like yours?
You would never ask if you knew what it's like in here. I mean, why anyone can be a Spacer's Choice Consumer Relations Choice Specialist. Just keep your nose clean and aim for the moon.
If you only know what it's like in here. If you only knew. I am addressing the man beneath the mask. Are you okay? I know you cannot blink. Still.
Damn it. No slogan for that one. Look, this hat, my job. It may not seem like much to a brave space captain, but they're all that I have. If there are self-made purgatories, then we all have to live in them. Mine can be no worse than someone else's. Now, if we're done with the chit-chat, I hope you don't mind if I make the most of this short life and try to be the best moon person I can be.
Sorry if I pushed it too hard, Martin.
It's fine. I should be stronger than this. Thanks for taking an interest. Speaking of interest, can I interest you in some quality budget goods? At Spacer's Choice, we cut corners so you don't have to.
Yeah, I've seen how bad that cut corners can be. Yeah, Miss Pierce, every November 1st, we always reset the points. You work for Spacer's Choice. Ever been to Edgewater?
Heard of it. My orientation Aetherwave showed that famous Saltuna cannery, which I'm sure smells as good as it looks.
Even better. Don't go. It's not so bad. They're struggling, but they've got good hearts. You aren't missing much. It's a dump. Don't go looking into it.
If you did, that'd be good, actually. They could use the help.
I'd have to go over my contract, but I don't think I'm allowed to leave Groundbreaker. Or this stall. So, what can I get you? Some soap? Everyone loves soap. Everyone will love you for using it, too.
That's... Do you got soap?
Have a look.
You're not wearing soap. They're not loving you. Remember that, chat. Oh! So we can buy the hat. Okay, so it's 3 armor. Why is there so many hats? Why is there so many hats? You asked for it, you got it. A genuine Spacer's Choice Moonman helmet. Based on the most popular mascot in SC, making marketing history. Enjoy. Okay, so. Just realized why they have 6 helmets. 1 for each companion. I love how it gives you a 5+ to lying, though. Yeah. Oops, chat. Sorry, hit the wrong button. Yeah, just stop hitting the wrong button. I mean, chat, if you could just stop hitting the wrong button, we would be fine. I just realized I can't even see it. Damn it. Okay. Parvati! Also, let's give her the better equipment now that I think about it, because she needs to survive. You look absolutely perfect. Yeah. I'm gonna give you the better stuff, because now that I think about it, she's so squishy. She's too squishy, chat. She's way too squishy. Let's see here. Chance to extract mods in the field. Armor rating, range damage. Probably have to go armor rating.
All right.
I'm not going anywhere, you hear?
Halcyon.
Go back to Byzantium, you gold-plated bastards.
Yeah, no one wants you on Groundbreaker.
Yeah.
These stairs are board property. Disperse now, or I'll detain you for trespassing.
Oh, real scary. You're really gonna arrest us on our station?
Yeah, this is Chief Junlei's ship. You don't own shit here.
Step back. I'm required by board bylaws to use excessive force.
Well, they're not even on the steps, though.
The Mardets would space you for trying, you waste of O2 scrubbers.
Yeah, O2 scrubbers.
Yeah, put them in their place.
Get out of here before I tell your captain what you've been getting up to on the clock.
Ah, whatever. We got a date at the Lost Hope anyway.
Is this really what you want to be doing with your life, Marcy? Guarding stairs for that walking mustache Udon fucking Bedford? I gotta get off this detail.
Wait. You have a name?
Hmm?
Yeah, you have a name, right?
Carry on. Huh? Move along. Hey! Got my sights on you.
I bet you do. I look good with this bowler hat.
I'm just gonna hang in the back and try not to touch anything.
We interrupt your regularly scheduled advertisement for the following story. Okay. It looks terrifying, by the way.
Do you have what it takes to defend your corporate township from the dangers of alien wildlife and the unemployed?
You need to have better security, my friend.
Talk to your local manager about applying.
Ah, yes. Wheeler messaged me you were coming. He must be the captain of the Unreliable, a vessel that used to be helmed by one Alex Hawthorne. And you are not he. Has something happened to my favorite scruffy freelancer?
Alex is dead. Forget Alex, why do you impound my ship? I'm gonna wring your scrawny neck, you s- Oh! Get back my ship. He's dead, buddy.
Oh no, this is terrible. My dear friend, what devilry is this? In whose miserable fever dream am I trapped?
Alex isn't important. I'm here to turn into Phineas Wells. Chat, my finger's going to number 4. Oh god, I can't control it. I'm trying. I can't, it's just strong.
What?
Oops, sorry. Wells, I meant smells. Really smells in here. Maybe you should open the door. Phineas Wells is the mad scientist wanted by the board, right? Before we get down to business, I need to know I can trust you. Can I trust you, mustache twirling man? It is National Redhead Day today, so can I trust you? Yes?
All right, I suppose. How might I assuage your fears?
Why do you work for the board?
Whom else would I work for? Those sublight thugs? That Tennyson woman? The sweaty masses in the groundside townships? The board is the only force for order in this rough and tumble colony of ours. Without them, we'd all starve to death or meet our end in a canid's jaws.
Do you enjoy working for them?
That's a curious question. I can't say I've ever considered how my personal satisfaction factors into the work I do. Permit me to answer your question in another way. In Byzantium, I was one among many. I often felt, lost in the hurry and expanse of the capital. Here I have a measure of power and suffer little oversight. It makes for a different kind of loneliness, but it's one I've found I can endure.
So does it tell me why I should trust you?
I understand. And I would ask the same of you, but I suspect... Well, I suspect I'd find your answers less than satisfactory, wouldn't I?
I want some best for the colony. That's why I want to turn Phineas in. I don't know how to answer that. You shouldn't trust me or anyone.
That's an unusual rhetorical tactic, but I admire your frankness and your gumption.
So, about Phineas.
Yes, do tell.
Denise Wells is the mad scientist wanted by the board, right?
Indeed. And you know where he is? Excelsior.
Oh, and there we are. I've removed the lock on your ship in a show of my gratitude.
Oh, no.
An apprehension of this caliber will be tremendous for my career. I'll send you straight away to my superiors in Byzantium, only... Oh, no. Oh, no.
Let me guess. There's a catch.
Just a teensy one. The teensiest. Nothing to, lie awake worrying about for nights on end or anything.
Crying in a corner. Yeah.
The thing is, I needed money. A lot of money. Quickly, for reasons.
So far, so entirely expected. What happened? What kind of reasons? Yeah, let's ask the question, chat.
That's really neither here nor there, don't you think?
Damn! One time I didn't want to go persuasion and charm. That's like, it's right there. You need money. What happened next?
I might have pawned my official board seal to Gladys, the black market fencier on the Groundbreaker. I can't authorize the paperwork you'll need to turn Phineas in without it.
To give away something so important to you, there must have been some curious reasons.
Mm-hmm.
I'll thank you not to question my motives, young miss. It was a mistake, and I'd like to put it behind me. It's only temporary, of course. I'd never leave something so important in the hands of someone of such a dubious moral character. I was going to buy it back once I raised the capital.
But I guess it's
10,000. So you'll need to get my seal back from her if you want to hand Phineas over to the board.
You gotta be. How stupid can you be?
Oh, it might surprise you.
I...
Gosh, that's quite a goof, sir. If you don't mind me saying.
I'm very well aware.
Okay.
Now, let's get back to business,
I mean, he's honest. Give him that. So before I can do the board a favor, turn over Wells, I need to do you a favor first.
That's the long and short of it, yes.
Fine, I'll talk to Gladys. Maybe I can work something out.
Thank you. Oh, I mean, thank you so much. So. I'm certain Gladys can be made, well, can probably be made to see reason. I'll be waiting eagerly for your return. Now, is there any way in which I might assist you?
I want to ask you something.
Be my guest.
Be my guest. My guest. What can you do? What do you do here exactly? What are those locked doors in the back? Ooh, yeah, let's go with that one.
A luxury stateroom reserved for Chairman Rockwell's use.
Does the chairman visit here often?
Oh, good law, of course not. He'd never set foot on this decrepit junk pile.
So why have it?
As this office is the primary embassy for the board on Groundbreaker, corporate bylaws specifically state a room must be maintained for the chairman's exclusive use.
So, what do you do here?
I'm the certified representative of the board's interests here on the Groundbreaker. I'm their eyes, ears, and busy little hands.
Big fish in a small station? Nice setup.
I have few complaints.
Can you get me to Stellar Bay?
Oh, good law. Who'd want to go to that toxic hell pit?
So, no?
No. Emphatically no. Unequivocally no. Immutably no.
Could have just said no. Didn't have to make it, you know, about being that word.
Do you have somewhere else to be, by any chance?
Does it seem hot in here to you?
Law, but it's miserable. My underarms are damp. How can I be expected to work in these conditions?
Oh,
Chief
no.
Tennyson is supposedly looking into the cause, but I've seen no action from her. Deplorable conduct. My superiors will be hearing about it. You can be certain of that.
Sweaty pits, yes. Why are there armed guards here?
Oh, you've noticed my friends. Wonderful. Aren't their guns very large? Tremendously impressive. They're here to keep the peace, of course.
A piece of what? Is there a pie around here? I'd love some pie, actually.
I'll admit, you've caught me quite off guard. No, I'm afraid there isn't any pie to be had.
What?
I don't reckon that's quite what Mr. Udom meant, Captain.
No pie?
Anyway, Groundbreaker makes much ado about its independent status and so resents any board presence, no matter how benign.
Nick, it's actually still audio commands. There are a slew of other audio commands that are active all the time. You keep calling offices on this promenade benign.